Henrik, how quickly did this deal come together? And give us a sort of a blueprint, if you will, in terms of how quickly you plan to utilize the funds of more than $1 billion that you hope to raise from this IPO.
Hi, Phil. Good to see you. Yeah, absolutely. You know, it came together really quickly. You know, we started looking at SPAC deals a couple of months ago. I really feel this is the best way to specifically in the automotive world, because as you know, when you're raising that much capital, it's very hard to do it privately. So I think it's the only way forward. So we were suddenly approached by a lot of SPACs within the last months, probably because of all the excitement in the market. And we really just saw Apollo as being the best for all the stakeholders at Fisker Inc. And we you know, finalized the deal extremely quickly. I have to say Apollo was very fast, very professional. We think it's the perfect partner for us, a very strong financial partner with great relationships all over the world. And we expect after this announcement that we would sort of go live, if you want, sometime in September, October timeframe, if everything goes well.
But Henrik, let's be honest here. Fisker Incorporated has no revenue. You don't have a product. You won't have a product at least until 2022. Why should investors invest in this company? Why should investors say, you know what, this is worth plunking down, I don't know, a couple $1,000s because we believe in the future of electric vehicles?
So I think we're doing something completely different than everybody else. And I think that's why we attracted a lot of very prominent investors like BlackRock, et cetera, because they really saw us coming up with a completely different business model. We are rethinking how the automotive industry should really work in the future. I think there's so much inefficiencies. I think the automotive industry is concentrating on the wrong things. We only talk about—
Henrik, let me stop you. Give me two inefficiencies. Give me two things you're going to do different than every other automaker, including Tesla.
Yeah, we have about 20 million vehicle overcapacity today in the automotive world. It's totally inefficient. There's no reason, specifically for a startup, to actually build a new manufacturing plant. We're going to outsource manufacturing. Secondly, the pillar of traditional hardware being the number one, we spend too much money, too much time. We have come up with a business model where we can bring vehicles to market in 29 months by sharing hardware with other OEMs, and we are well in plans to do that and finalizing them. Those are two important inefficiencies where today and in the future, we'll have to spend a lot more money on software, a lot more money on the consumer itself, the digital experience. And that's where we are putting over our money. Of course, emotional design is important. ESG is very important for us. We have, for instance, a board with three women, very diverse board. So I think there's a lot of other areas where we want to concentrate on than traditional automakers do today. And I think we're going to see a revolution in the automotive industry.
Henrik, I don't think anybody denies that the future is electric in the automotive industry. Nobody's quite sure, though, if that means 10 years, 15 years, 20 years from now. And let's be honest, the king of the mountain is Tesla. How do you convince people the Ocean, which is the vehicle we were looking at, is every bit as good as a Tesla right now? Because nobody in this auto industry has been able to knock Tesla off that mountain.
Well, I don't think you need to knock Tesla off a mountain. I think they've done a terrific job, and they opened up the market to really show that you know, electric vehicles can be desirable and they work even better than gasoline cars. But I think this is a gigantic market, you know, of 80 million vehicles globally in so many different segments. First of all, the Fisker Ocean is not, you know, a crossover hatchback. It's a real good-looking SUV, which is very different from everything you've seen in the market. Secondly, we have a very unique flexi lease model where you can actually lease this vehicle and give it back anytime. So we have a completely different value proposition. And finally, we really are aiming at making the world's most sustainable vehicle. And I think young people who today are coming into, or maybe in 2 or 3 years are getting into the market of electrification, they're going to look also about what the company does to help the world, to become a better world, a cleaner world. And that's something that our brand stands for. And I think we have many attributes, I think, where we're differentiated from our competitors.